Dear children, how are you all? Are you all staying safe at home? Okay, good. First class, we started our first lesson. Happy as I am. Happy as I am. In that lesson, I taught you contented and discontented child. Contented and discontented child. A child who is contented is a happy child. A child who is discontented is an angry, unhappy child. Okay? Do you remember the concept what I have taught last class? Yes, good. Children, first lesson, happy as I am, happy as I am. This is Swaroop, this is Maya. Swaroop is enjoying whatever he had with him. And he is a contented child. But this Maya is always angry and she is discontented with whatever she had with her. So she has an unhappy life. A child who is contented is a happy child. A child who is discontented is an angry, unhappy child. Let's read the story, The Big Small House. The Big Small House. The character name, Wayne. Wayne was always complaining. He had a big family, he had a wife and 6 growing children. They had just one room to live in. See this, Wayne, his wife and children. See, 6 growing children. Wayne always used to tell, there is so little space in this house. His wife always tells, I am always tired as there is no corner where I can rest. The children says, no place to play. Wayne decided to talk to his friend about it. He thought that his wife's friend would know what to do. He went to meet his friend. He explained his sad story. I live in a one-room house. We all eat, sleep, live, play and study and work there. We often tread on each other's toes and that makes us fight. By hearing this, his friend asked him, do you have any animals? Wayne replied, yes, I have a cow, a calf, a donkey and some chickens. They live in a shed outside. His friend told him to take the animals inside your house. Let the animals live together with you for a week. Wayne was surprised. This was not what he expected to hear, but he did as he was told. His one-room house became even more crowded and full of noise. Cluck, cluck. Chickens makes a noise. Cluck, cluck. The next morning, Wayne went back to his friend. It is terrible. The animals are all over the house and we are squeezed into a corner. And the smell, what can we do? Wayne asked his friend. His friend replied, take the chickens out. Wayne did as he was told but returned the next day. Again, he came to meet his friend the next day. The chickens are gone but the hay, animal food. The animals are champing and stamping the hay into everyone's eyes and hair. By hearing this, Wayne's friend told him to take the cow and the calf out. Wayne rushed back to do this, but was back the next day. Next day also he came to meet his friend. He came and complained that the donkey has chewed up his children's books. By hearing this, now also the friend replied him to take the donkey out. So Wayne took the donkey outside. All the animals were now back in the shed. After some time later, Wayne met his friend in the market. His friend asked him, "How are you, Wayne? How is the family?" Wayne replied to his friend, "Wonderful, very happy. The animals are back in their shed. The house is now big enough for us to be comfortable." That's the title, The Big Small House. Now the small house became the big one. Okay, children, you all enjoyed the story. Okay. Children, now let's understand. There are two important words for you to learn: contentment, discontentment. Contentment, discontentment. To be contented is to be happy with what you have. To be discontented is to be unhappy with what you have. It is wanting more. There are many things you would like to have: a new bicycle, a new video game, a new dress or shoes. We may think, if only I had these new shoes, I would be the happiest person. But would it make us happy after we get new shoes? Wouldn't there be something else that we would want? What makes you happy? Think about it. You may have got good marks in your test. You had a great time cuddling up with grandmother for a bedtime story last night. These are the kinds of things that money cannot buy, but which make you happy. Make a habit of counting all the good things in your life. This will make you a more contented person. Share the things you have. Make a habit of sharing. This will make you even happier. Do you know people who have a lot of things but are still discontented? Being discontented is also a habit. It is a habit we must break out of. Being contented makes us thankful for what we have. When we are contented and happy, we can do our work well and help others too. Being discontented makes us hard to live with. Okay, children, so you all must be a contented children. Okay, children, now it's time to give your question answers. First, I will give reading for these notes. Lesson 1, Happy as I am. Happy as I am. First Roman letter, choose the correct answers. Choose the correct answers. First one, a child who is contented is a dash child. Happy child. A child who is contented is a happy child. A, happy. B, unhappy. C, naughty. The answer is happy. Second one, Wayne had a dash family. Wayne had a big family. A, small. B, medium. C, big. The answer is big. Third one, the animals live in a dash outside. The animals live in a shed outside. A, tent. B, shed. C, cottage. B, shed. Fourth question, Wayne decided to meet his dash. Wayne decided to meet his friend. A, friend. B, teacher. C, relative. A, friend. Fifth one, make a habit of counting all the dash things in your life. Make a habit of counting all the good things in your life. A, good. B, bad. C, sad. Good. Answer is good. Okay, children, then next we move to fill in the blanks. Fill in the blanks. First one, the title of the story is The Big Small Dash. The title of the story is The Big Small House. Second one, Wayne had dash growing children. Wayne had six growing children. Third one, chickens make the noise cluck cluck. Dash make the noise cluck cluck. Chickens make the noise cluck cluck. Fourth one, the animals are stamping the dash into everyone's eyes and hair. The animals are stamping the hay into everyone's eyes and hair. Fifth one, sometime later, Wayne met his friend in the dash. Sometime later, Wayne met his friend in the market. These are the fill in the blanks question answers. Now moving to match the following. 1. Discontented, unhappy. Discontented, unhappy. Second one, one room. One room. Wayne had only one room to live. 3. Children play. Children play. There is no space to the children play. Cow cough. Cow cough. Donkey books. Donkey books. Donkey chewed up the children's books. Okay, that's all. Have totally 3 Roman letters. Children, when you are writing, take a new booklet in a fresh page. Don't forget to put the date, page number, and use blue and black ink pen to write. See this title and lesson one, you have to write using black ink pen. This heading also you have to use black ink pen. And this question answers, the question you can write using blue ink pen, but the answer you have to write with the black ink pen. Choices you can use blue ink pen. Okay, same for the filling the blanks, you have to write the question using blue ink pen, but the answer you have to write with black ink pen. Don't forget to underline the answers, that is dash. Okay, so don't forget to underline the answers. Similarly, for match the following also, you have to write this total using blue ink pen, and you must mention this number using black ink pen. Okay, children. Okay, children, I'll share these notes through WhatsApp group. When you are writing, write neatly and legibly. Each and every letters must be visible. Don't strike out often. If you have any mistake, just give only one single stroke. Just cut using a pencil. Just strike out the mistake. Don't use your ink pen here and there for striking out the mistakes. Okay, children, handwriting must be very, very neat. Okay. Okay, children, that's all today's class. So always be happy with whatever you have with you. Okay. Thank you, children. Take care. Bye bye. Be happy always.